ABCD is a rhombus in which altitude from D to AB bisects AB. So angle A and angle B are here. ABCD is a rhombus. Rhombus means what? All sides are equal. Diagonals bisect each other at 90 degrees. Always remember these basics. Okay. Now what is next given? The altitude from D bisects AB in half. So AE equals to EB. This is the altitude and these two are half of each of AB, right? So AE equals to EB. Okay. So all sides of a rhombus are equal. Now in triangle ADE and triangle BDE, ADE and BDE. Now what is the case? DE equals to D, same side. Okay. Then angle DEA equals to angle DEB, 90 degrees both. Why? Altitude. Altitude means 90 degrees. Okay. AE equals to EB, given. That's what is given. Bisects the AB. DE bisects AB. So that's why given. So triangle ADE congruent to triangle BDE. ADE and BDE. Why? SAS test, right? Okay, what are the tests of congruence? See, these are the, you might have forgotten. These are the tests. SSS, SAS, ASA, AAS and RHS. RHS means right hypotenuse side. Okay, this is only for right angle triangle. SSA is not a test for congruence. Okay, so there are five. Okay, let's get back. So, ADE congruent to triangle BDE, SAS test. Therefore, what? ADE equals to BDY, CPCT, corresponding parts of congruent triangles. So, here now AD equals to BD. But also you know one thing. AB equals to AD. Why? AB equals to AD. Sides of a rhombus. So, what you have now? AD equals to AB equals to BD. Right? All the three. So, these three sides are equal. What does it mean? Triangle ABD is an equilateral triangle. ABD is an equilateral. So, angle A is what? Angles of equilateral triangle are 60 degrees. So A equals to 60. That is angle DAB equals to 60. That is one answer required. We want angle A and angle B, right? That is our final target. So you have A now 60. Now you have to find out B. How to find B? Here. AD and BC are parallel to each other. Why? They are the sides of a rhombus and sides of a rhombus are equal and parallel, right? So these are parallel. Therefore what happens? DAB and CBA are what? Interior angles, right? What are interior angles? See, there are three types of triangles: alternate angles, interior angles and corresponding angles. So there are further separated, they can be alternate interior angles, alternate exterior angles. They are always equal. Alternate interior form Z shape and exterior are opposite to these Z. Then same side interior angle and alternate exterior angle, that is done. Same side exterior angle. This interior, that is exterior. Okay. They are supplementary. Interior angles are always supplementary. Let it be same side interior or same side exterior. These same side angles, they are equal. Now, supplementary. Then corresponding angles. Corresponding angles means they are on the same side. Okay. Of the parallel lines and of the transversal. So, above means both above. Here interior angle, there is a difference between interior and this corresponding. Interiors are, if one is above, other is below. That is, they are between these two parallel lines and they are corresponding are on the same side and same level. Means up so up, down so down. Okay. So angle DAB and angle ABC are interior angles. They are supplementary. So add them 60. AB no 60 plus CBA equals to 180. Okay. So CBA equals to what? 180 minus 60. That is 120. That's what we want. Angle B is 120. Angle A is 60. Next. Which of the following quadrilaterals is not a parallelogram? Now, see, this is a parallelogram. What is the basic feature? Opposite sides are equal and parallel. So in rectangle, are opposite sides equal and parallel? Yes. In square, are opposite sides equal and parallel? Yes. In rhombus, are opposite sides equal and parallel? Yes. Okay. In kite, are opposite sides equal and parallel? No. Why? In a kite, always adjacent sides means one pair of adjacent sides is congruent. Always remember, one pair means this pair is congruent to each other and this pair is congruent to each other, means these two sides are congruent.